Okay, so what is up guys? Now Frustraeder is back at it again for another Bitcoin update. As always, every day. No, so hindi pa kayo nakapag-like, comment and subscribe, so you may feel free to do so. No, so today, no, nandito tayo ngayon sa ating daily chart kay Bitcoin dominance, no. So it looks like the Bitcoin dominance is again retesting the EMA 20 dito sa daily. No, if ever na magkaroon nga ng drastic move si BTC again, this could further go up or make a bounce, okay? But again, wala naman masyadong bago dyan sa price action na yan, no? But again, dito sa ating RSI is, meron tayo na, di ba, na plot dito na potential symmetrical triangle pattern, which is this one, di ba? So, it looks like it has broken down in this point or in this area. So, again, the target for that would be around this area, di ba? So, that is going to be around 37.8 RSI on the daily time frame. But again, pwede pa yan magkaroon ng bounce dito sa ating potential support area, which is in this case is itong area na to. Pwede natin itong i-watch out. Okay? So, bakit? Kasi nga, meron siya ditong 3 bounces, di ba? 1, 2, and 3 bounces. So, potentially, pwede yan magkaroon dito ng 4th bounce before retesting this area. And if this area is going to reject the price action here, pwede yan mag-breakdown. Okay? Kasi gagawa siya ng consistent lower lows. Okay? So, that is just my opinion. It doesn't have to be yours. Okay? Just take that as a not a financial advice, okay? So again, if you haven't seen our Frustraeders Learning School, this is uploaded dito rin syempre sa ating YouTube channel, no? So I have uploaded 6 episodes and I am still planning to upload the episode 7. I think within this week kaya ko siyang matapos, no? So you feel free to check it out. Ano ba tong FLS? This is the Frustraeders Learning School where I upload everything I know about trading. So, tinuturo ko siya for free. No? So, pwede nyo siyang tingnan. Okay? So, tuloy tayo. Dito tayo sa ating Bitcoin US Dollar chart. So, I think alam nyo naman kung ano nangyari kanina. Diba? So, mamaya tingnan natin yung CME chart kung ano nang itsura niya. But for the meantime, tingnan muna natin itong ating 1-hour time frame. Okay? So, kung magbe-base tayo sa price action, no? We are clearly seeing a huge candle or bearish engulfing candle with a good volume, no? I can say that it's not yet a volume spike, but this is a good volume for this candle, no? So, bearish engulfing candle, so bearish engulfing volume, so that is a good support or a healthy support, no? And kung titingnan natin, it has currently retested this EMA 50 and the EMA 20 on the hourly time frame, no? And if I am to make a support and resistance area, no? Kung titingnan natin mabuti in this area, no? Siguro pwede natin simulan dyan. No, we are currently seeing a retest as well. So this is a good support and resistance area. Ayan, no, meron siya ditong bounce na break niya, 'di ba? Meron siya ditong bounces, no? Meron siya ditong bounce and then dito may bounce, 'di ba? May support dito, support here and then support here and then dito na break na niya. And ngayon it looks like it is retesting this. And then based nga dito sa ating or sa in-upload ko dito sa supports and resistances, mas healthy siya if the trend is going to break a support and then confirm it naman as a new resistance, no? So ngayon, hindi pa siya confirmed resistance since hindi pa nagko-close yung kandila. Okay? So pwede natin yung abangan. Pero yung gusto ko pang isang i-point out dito sa ating hourly time frame is pwede ko na siguro itong alisin, no? Alisin ko na to and then ito. Again, we have showed this or mentioned this as well. This is a potential rising wedge pattern, 'di ba? The target for this is this area. Okay? That area is the target for this end. Na-hit na niya and it even exceeded that area. Okay? So, ano pa yung isa kong gustong ipakita? So, di ba, meron pa tayo dito isang mas malaking rising wedge. Okay? So, ito. Di ba, as I have said, this is for me a fake out. Why? Kasi, nung nag-breakout siya dito, no, hindi niya ni-retest as a new support itong ating recent resistance area. Di ba? So, para maka-invalidate yan, gusto natin makakita ng ganitong movement. But, ang nangyari is, nag-breakout siya and then bumalik siya sa low end. It even retested this area as a resistance again. Na-reject ulit siya dito, di ba? And obviously, no? So, yan. So, for me, this is still valid. And that being said, the target for this conservative target is this area. And kung titignan natin, na-hit na niya yung area na yan. So, again, the aggressive target is the bottom of the wedge, which is in this case is around the 15 area, 15 RSI in the hourly time frame. So, pwede ba yung ma-hit? So, potentially, pwede, no? Pero again, meron pa siyang isa pang binubuong pattern dito. So, 1 hour time frame, no? So yan, let us not overanalyze syempre, pero kasi yun nga, I'm seeing this potential pattern and this could play out, no? So pwede yan mag-breakout dito. So this is a bullish engulfing, this is a bullish expanding triangle, no? Pero yan, this could break out and target up to here around the 74.17 RSI, but again, this can still go down and retest this area, no? So that is not yet guaranteed, but yan. And yung nakita natin for the hourly time frame, no, as of now. So dito naman tayo sa ating 4 hour time frame, no? Again, we have mentioned this potential breakdown, and true enough, it broke down, it retested this green support and resistance line twice, no? So paano nasaan yun? So zoom in natin, so this one twice, no? So nagkaroon lang siya ng wick above those areas and the candle closed below this green support and resistance area. And after that, nagkaroon siya ng bearish engulfing candle with a good amount of volume, no? So ngayon, kakabukas lang itong bagong ng bagong 4 hour candle, and it looks like it has retested this EMA 20 on the 4 hour time frame. And if that is going to close again below that 4 hour EMA 20, since tinatch niya yan, so that is going to further confirm it as a bearish candle. Pero again, that is going to be even more bearish if this current candle will be closing below, I think, 38.3K, no? So tingnan natin kung anong potential scenario na mangyayari dyan, no? And yeah, that's it. So alisin ko muna to, no? So yan. So dito naman tayo sa daily, no? So sa daily time frame, the daily recent daily candle, no? The recent daily candle, which is this one from a weekend, no? So itong ating candle na to is closed bearish, but again, wala siya masyadong volume. But this recent daily candle closed below our ascending triangle's support and resistance area. Okay? So ayan na yung ating ascending triangle. So nag-close siya below that area. So anong ibig sabihin nun? If that is going to be a breakdown, a confirmed breakdown, gusto sana natin ng malaking volume. But so far, since galing nga siya sa weekend, sa Sunday candle, no, so wala siya masyadong volume. But still, the volume is still a bearish engulfing volume. No, so sa current candle, if again this candle closes, I think below this 37.4K area, that would further confirm the movement or a downward action, no? So syempre gusto natin makakita ng volume, no? Kasi as of right now, it is currently testing this area, no? So this area is a good area for a rejection as of now. Kasi nga nag-close siya below that, and then if this is going to retest this area, potentially, we can expect it as a new resistance since it is a strong support from before, no? So that's it for the daily time frame, no? Pwede na siguro tayo ngayon pumunta sa weekly time frame. But before that, if you are a new to trading, or if you are looking for a platform to shift from your current platform or exchange na where you are trading, I suggest you try Bityard. Why? Kasi this is a platform that is lower, they are charging lower fees, no? Bakit? Kasi they are not charging when you are opening a position, but they are just only charging, or they are charging transaction fees only when you are closing your positions, no? So dito you can trade also crypto, not only crypto but also commodities and forex. They also have the copy trade feature, and they also give mystery box as a surprise for everyone that is using their platform, no? So that being said, pwede na tayo, I think, pumunta sa weekly time frame, no? So dito sa weekly time frame, the weekly recent weekly candle closed as a bearish candle, no? Again, we have two, or siguro we can say 3 or 5 candles that is consecutively has huge wicks on the upper parts, given na lalo itong last two candles. So these are weekly time frame, so mabagal ito gumalaw, no? So again, the bias for this is to retest the EMA 100 since it has been rejected from this descending resistance, support and resistance line. Okay? So that is just my bias, no? So kung titignan natin maigi, we have been on track since here and then here. Alam nyo na yan if you are so nakasubaybay kayo dito, no? So if this is going to close below the EMA 100, that would further make a bearish cross from the EMA 20 and the EMA 50. Okay, so this is the weekly time frame, and again, we had this potential rising wedge or a bearish flag, no? So again, the target for this, if this is a a rising wedge, is again the bottom of the wedge, which is in this case, this is around 37.6. But if this is a bear flag, no, so the conservative target would be around this area, no, so that would be around 33.63%. No, so kung titingnan natin, it has broken down and it looks like it is about to retest this recent support area to confirm it as a new resistance, no. Pwede natin niyang i-adjust dyan, so pwede pa siya magkaroon ng further upside, but again, tingnan natin kung ano mangyayari sa kanya, no. So again, meron pa ako isang nabanggit sa inyo kahapon na chart, no. So babaan natin yung time frame and then punta tayo sa ating CME chart. So this is going to be a bonus. So di ba sabi natin, if the recent price action is going to close above this area around 39.1k, is magkakaroon siya ng gap, CME gap. But again, it did not close above that area, no. So tingnan natin March 12 candle, and then dito siya nag-close, di ba? This is the March 12, kita nyo ba yung date? That is the March 12 candle, and this is the March 14 candle. So pwede ko na itong alisin and then make a new one, no. So if this is the new one, so I can make this, no. So pwede ko to i-zoom in, okay. So if this is the new one and the candle is nag-open siya dito and it made a CME gap, but again, it has been filled as soon as possible. So diba ganun siya nag-work, okay. So that is a very small gap, so ngayon binabalikan niya. As of right now, meron ulit siyang CME gap. Yun, no? Kung titingnan nyo, meron siyang maliit na gap dito. Pwede siya ma-fill and pwede rin hindi. So, tingnan natin. No? So, ayun, dito may gap ulit siya sa ilalim. So, potentially, pwede siya ulit bumagsak. No? So, siguro kung umabot kayo sa part ng video na to, pwede nyo i-comment niya sa baba. Uy, nagkaroon nga ng maliit na gap. No? So, again, maraming salamat. And if you are looking for a trading community, you can check the description box down below. No? So if nandiyan lahat yung gusto nyo makita na link, yung social media ko, yung mga Telegram, Discord, no. So nandiyan din yung ating registration link for Bityard if you want to try it, no. And then for the KCG and PLE trading community, nandiyan na rin sa baba yung description per community, so you can check it out. So yun lang, again, maraming salamat. As always, secure your profits and protect your capital, cut losses without mercy. Yun lang, everyone, let's go.